All right, so today we are going to talk about, not that, the Cirrus Flex camera and the turnstile antennas. So, should be pretty short. So I guess first we've got the tuna can here. And so what that means is in the Cal Poly design specifications and NanoRacks, you are allowed, technically, if you're over 3U, but we asked them and they said sure, to have a tuna can space. And it goes in the deployer, which is it's kind of hard to like envision right now, but basically the rails get stuck into the box, and so this part of the rail will be hitting like the deployer, and there's a giant hole in it, and so this goes into that hole. If that makes sense. And so this is just marking off the space that we have for the tuna can, which is actually what it's called. Fun fact. And so our CFC goes inside of it. CFC is Cirrus Flex Cam. And this is being designed in a joint project with UMBC, University of Maryland, Baltimore County. And they worked on HARP, and we reached out to them as part of our, Oregon Space Grant, UTEEP, and said, "Hey, can you help us?" And so they're the ones that have been helping us out, and they picked out this giant lens, and we're working on a cage to mount it to the card. And then there's also some interesting stuff that happens in terms of thermal stuff. So the sensor has to be kept cool, and so we'll need like a radiator. And we'll probably actually extend this into the clamps. And so a lot of this is still really under development. But Cirrus Flex camera, I think most of you know, but I'll say it again for if anyone watches the video. But it is to measure the global distribution of cirrus clouds in the atmosphere to help with global climate models. And so cirrus clouds are really hard to detect because they look like ice when you're looking down from space. And so there's some instruments that do it, but they're on really big satellites. So this is something that hasn't been done before in a CubeSat. So it's kind of interesting and definitely difficult to get something in such a small CubeSat. And yeah, so that is the Cirrus Flex Cam. And Emilio, do you want to talk about turnstile antennas?
I can talk about it a little bit. The turnstile antennas are the four deployable antennas that are going to be sitting on the end of Borisat. You can kind of see them in those four. I don't know. They're all coming out about 90 degrees from each other and about 45 degrees from the plane where the camera sits, where all the cards sit. I don't know. What more do you want me to say about them?
Talk about what they're made out of.
Sure. They're all made out of a composite of fiberglass and resin. Sorry, epoxy. They're made so that they will be rolled up, so they sit really close to the actual plane. And then when it's deployed, we burn a burn wire, and they should roll outwards and snap into shape. They have a couple metal elements inside them to actually work as the antennas. And yeah.
Yep. It's funny because everyone, all of us are on the turnstile team
Yeah.
because thermal's not here today. So, yeah, this is really for if anyone watches this on YouTube, they can see what the turnstile antenna is. And so, yeah, these are all under development by us at Portland State. We took over from Calvin and his capstone team and trying to get them to fit better. So, like, these are some of the mounts, and we've got it in a pinwheel design under our end cap. And yeah, still under development. A lot of work from the past year, actually, is about when we started. So I don't know why there's a random fastener sticking out right here, but. Okay. So, yeah, I guess that's it. Any questions? Any thoughts?
Can you talk a little bit about how the transdural antennas are going to be deployed?
Yeah, so we don't really have, I wish I could show you it. We don't have it in CAD, but they're going to roll up like little fruit roll-ups and fit into this little space here. So if you picture like a fruit roll-up here, which is the antenna, and then right now we are planning on having a burn wire kind of loop over and keep it constrained. And that burn wire will go into this purple PCB and be attached to a resistor. And the resistor, when we're in space, will have current sent through it. So it'll heat up and burn that wire. And then these will unravel and deploy. So that's where some issues come, because we have to, one, make sure that we can actually keep it constrained that way. And two, you have to have having some duplicity in it. So having more than one burn wire. So in case one breaks when it shouldn't, then you still have a backup. And then also making sure that these aren't going to relax in their stowed state to turn into an actual fruit roll-up that doesn't unravel on its own. A lot of material stuff goes into it as well. Anything else? No? Okay. So, cool. That's pretty much it for all the insides then. And then next week will be frames and wedges. Stop.